Hi friends, welcome to Smart News Digital. Let's have discussion for the date July 30th, 2018. These are the five topics today we are going to discuss. Today's first topic is BRICS Summit 2018. Recently in Johannesburg, 2018 BRICS Summit has been held. What is BRICS? BRICS is a group of five emerging economies, namely Brazil, Russia, India, China, and South Africa. Before South Africa has been inducted in 2010, it has been called as BRIC countries. The theme of 2018 summit is BRICS in Africa, collaboration for inclusive growth and shared prosperity in the fourth industrial revolution. Since 2018 BRICS summit has been held in South Africa, South Africa has proposed these new areas for BRICS cooperation, namely establishment of working group on peacekeeping, establishment of vaccine research center, establishment of BRICS gender and women's forum, and establishment of BRICS tourism and track cooperation. Let's see something about BRICS history. First BRICS summit was held in Russia in 2009 before South Africa joined into BRICS. The last BRICS summit has been held in China. The outcome of last summit is Xiamen Declaration. The measures that are taken in Trump's regime is really deterring a free trade. So it is important for BRICS countries to devise a policy in such a way that it firmly support multilateral trading regime and also it advance global economic governance reforms and to increase the representation and voice of emerging countries and developing countries in international arena. US has been imposing trade restrictions on Chinese goods, which may lead to global trade war. Today's second topic is conviction under SCST Act is just 27% in 2014 and 16. Recently, Home Ministry released a report which says that only 27% of people are convicted under SCST Prevention of Atrocity Act. This report comes when wide ranging of discussion is going on about SCST Atrocities Act. Let's see what are the reasons for the low conviction rate. First reason is there is a delay in lodging the FIR itself. Secondly, witnesses and complainants becoming hostile. Thirdly, absence of proper scrutiny by the prosecution before they file the charge sheet in front of court. And there is a lack of proper presentation of cases itself. And prosecution unable to prove the charges. And there is a long pendency of trials. And there is a lack of corroborative evidence also. For ensuring speedy trials, this act provides for establishment of exclusive special courts. According to this, in India, there is 195 exclusive special courts have been set up. Why this particular act has been in the limelight for quite some time is because in March 20, Supreme Court held that under this act, several innocent people, honest officers are being convicted. Following this judgment, Bharat Bandh call given by various SCST organizations, Supreme Court held that there is no intention to dilute this SCST Prevention of Atrocities Act. It is only to protect innocent people. The third topic is layers of protection. Recently, the amendments to the Prevention of Corruption Act 1988 have been adopted by both houses of the parliament. Former Prime Minister Manmohan Singh told that Section 13(1)(d) of this particular act has been misused widely. What it says, under this, public servants are culpable for securing a pecuniary advantage for another without any public interest. Under this provision, many honest officers have been convicted, have been accused. It had a chilling effect and it deterred bold decision-making officials. And this particular provision was amended recently. This will have a liberating effect for honest officials who are performing their duty. The recent amendment restricts the criminal misconduct of two offenses. What are they? The first one is, I am a government servant. I have been given a government vehicle. When I use that government vehicle for my private use, I will be held. I will be responsible. I will be liable. The second is, I have an income, but I do not know the source of income. That is, I cannot cite what are the sources through which I earned that. There is a new provision which says that citizens are liable for giving bribe, which means that if I give a bribe, I will be punished. It is in line with UN Convention Against Corruption. The exception says that if I am compelled to give a bribe, I will not be punished. If I voluntarily give, I will be punished. This particular exception comes into picture when I report to the authority within 7 days. The most unacceptable change in this act is Introduction of prior approval norm to start an investigation. It is putting another layer, which is time-taking process. Public servants have to be protected against unfair prosecution, but at the same time, a genuine drive against corruption has to be protected by a package of legislative measures. Legislative measures should contain penal provisions. We have to create ombudsman like Lokpal and Lokayukta, and we have to assure citizens a time-bound services, and we also ensure that whistleblowers are protected. Today's fourth topic is keeping friends close. It talks about India-Iran relationship. India-Iran relations have been properly, carefully built by our past governments, because Iran is not just another partner. Iran is not just energy supplier. It is more than that. It provides alternative route to Afghanistan. We are building a Chabahar port in Iran. US considers Iran as its adversary, and it puts a lot of economic sanctions on Iran. And US wants India to reduce its energy imports from Iran. If India fails, India may attract economic sanctions. This was US statement. The Iranian Revolution 1979 brought a sea change in Tehran's foreign policy. According to this foreign policy, it considers US is a principal adversary to Iran. Pakistan was getting closer to US, and Soviet military intervened in Afghanistan. In this time, Iranian leadership was suspicious about Pakistan and its president. This was the opportunity before India. Why India did not take full advantages of this anti-Pakistan orientation of Iran? Two reasons. First, India was worried that getting closer to Iran may provoke US. Second, that India was worried about Islamic content that was present in Iranian Revolution. Recently, India-Iran relations have been improved a lot because of energy dependency and trade dependency. We have to build more and more because Iran is our reliable partner. India should not worry about empty threats by USA because Iran is more important in our region. Today's fifth topic is fast tracks aim to quicken pace of journey through toll booths. The government have introduced radio frequency identification device based fast tag system for vehicles crossing toll gates on the country's highway network. Around 26 lakhs cars and trucks are using this technology. That is, they are using windscreen mounted tags to shorten their journey time. You might have seen that in toll plaza, number of vehicles standing in a queue to pay toll fee. It is waste of time. Vehicles are standing for no purpose. Near non-stop movement is taking place around 400 toll plazas out of 479 toll plazas in various national highways. How this particular device works? The tag with a quick response code and an identification number is affixed on the windscreen of the vehicle. Then that particular tag is linked with a FastTag account with a bank of his or her choice. Dedicated FastTag lanes have to be provided in order to avoid stopping to pay a toll tax. In many toll plazas, these dedicated FastTag lanes are not there, so the purpose of this particular scheme is not yet fully realized. In many toll plaza, the antenna has a range of only 6 meters, so the vehicles which are going towards toll plaza has to go around 10 km per hour. This scheme is working with a technological help. For example, the user will receive an SMS alert regarding the charge debited from his account or her account. Similarly, to encourage the FastTag, National Highway Authority of India provides 5% of refund every month. What we need is free flow of vehicles, an increase in return on investment for transporters, and also we have to bring down the logistic cost. In many toll plazas, these RFID readers don't work because switching over to new technology is not acceptable to many people. If you see who are the biggest users of this FastTag, they are trucks and taxis. Every day 40 lakh transactions are taking place in toll booth, around which 12.5% or 5 lakh transactions are using this technology. But if you see based on the income, it is around 25% of income comes under this scheme. It shows that most of the users belong to this trucks and taxis category. Thank you.